Howdy everyone, it's me once again, the one and only Killer Rodan. And today, once again, I have another martial arts film for you to review, folks. And this one is Romeo Must Die, starring Jet Li. And, you know, of course, the whole thing with, you know, Alicia. You know, may her soul rest in peace and whatnot. So, I guess this is more of the more modern day kung fu movies I have. Which, yeah, reviewing the more up to date kind of martial art films seems to be a real rarity for me. But anyway, yeah, I need to review a Jet Li movie because, you know, it's obviously on my to do list, of course. But anyway, as usual, let's talk about the plot, shall we? Oh, yes, sorry, folks. So yes, there's this character who is waiting for someone in this nightclub, in this, you know, in this town, when suddenly there's an angry individual who tries to start a fight with him, of course, and his father's right-hand man and henchman pulls him out, and let's just say there's a brief fight that comes in. I mean, don't get to see our main character in this film, of course. You know, Jet Li does play this character, and he has to pretty much, you know, we get to see him like always doing some fighting, obviously. And this is the thing, folks. You get to see Jet Li doing his what he does best, of course. And of course, he wants to play some type of character in here. But anyway, let's just say that our main character, he basically is this type of a person because he wants to do what's right. So there's this officer whom seeks out his brother's killer and fails for the daughter of a businessman whom is involved in this money deal kind of a thing with his father. And obviously this whole mess, crazy plot, centering our main character and whatnot. And I don't regret watching this at all. I really did enjoy this film as a whole. I can say that this one was pretty well done. And yeah, you can tell this had more money put, quite a bit of money put into it compared to some of the other stuff I've seen. And I can say that this one is definitely something let's watch. I watch, if you ask me. So, yeah. This one's pretty crazy, as you can see, folks. And, yeah, like I say, it's right here. Yep. The wildest action scenes since The Matrix. Okay, that's a bit of a bold statement, don't you think? So, anyway, folks. The martial arts scenes are pretty well done. Yeah, even when they're well done, I can say the action scenes are well still feels, you know, different compared to the more, you know, old school stuff I've reviewed. But oh well. So in some ways, I kind of like some of the other martial art films. I've seen better. Yeah, some of the old stuff I do like better than this movie. But this is far from a bad film. It's well constructed. There's a pretty solid story, of course. I did like the music track. The soundtrack is actually really well done. I really like the music that was done here, folks. I did like what was done with the music. The composing was really nicely put together. And the acting for the most part was, you know, decent, I guess you could say. And I can say that this is definitely something I wouldn't mind watching again. Yeah, I have it on DVD for fuck's sake. So yeah, Jet Li was actually pretty good in this, of course. Obviously. That's definitely a good thing here, folks. Oh boy. I'm definitely a top secret agent, and I seem to watch a lot of kung fu movies. Oh boy. Spending so much time watching type of movies, you'd think I'd be doing some other stuff. So anyway, folks. Yeah, this one's pretty cool. This is a pretty well-made film. I'll say that this movie is definitely does have its charm, of course. It definitely has its moments. I mean, there's some things I would like to bring up, but, you know, I don't want to spoil it, really. So I can say the cast of characters are actually pretty likable in their own way. And of course, our main character, played by Jet Li, wants to do the right thing, obviously. Which of course, having the main characters always do the right thing, became like a trademark for these movies, of course. And that doesn't have to be a bad thing, obviously. So the film as a whole, it does have some pretty exciting sequences. Yes, sirree. So, yeah, just have fight scenes that take place in various areas, of course. Which I do think is a good thing, obviously. And, yeah. But it never feels tiresome. And it never feels like it lost some energy. It never feels like it lost some gasoline or anything, so to speak. Like a car. It never got boring, is what I'm saying. Never got bored at all. So that's definitely a good thing there, folks. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, that's definitely a plus there, obviously. I can say that the editing wasn't actually not that bad, really. The editing wasn't actually not that bad. So the entire movie has its own different feel to it. No, the entire style of this film is totally different compared to some of the martial art films I've reviewed in the past. So, yeah, cinema has changed in a lot of ways. Ever since back in the day, cinema has definitely changed. Yes, sir. Well, I wouldn't know because I keep saying I was around for quite a while, for over 100 years. Holy hell! I know I don't look it, but that's the thing, folks. So anyway, Romeo Must Die is definitely a well-made movie. It does a lot of stuff to enjoy about it. Yes, sir. So, I would say, even if I check this one out, give it a shot, give it a chance. Even if you just watch it on DVD, that's fine, of course. This is just the standard DVD format version, I guess. So anyway, this film, it gets an overall rating of a 7.010. It gets a 7.010 for me. And of course, as you always, thank you for watching and take care. Till next time. Oh yeah.